recording. Good morning, beautiful people. Cory Dooley here. All right, so I have a bench. By the way, if any of you guys want some weights, or there's plenty here. I am coming back in like a week or 2 weeks, so let me know. There doesn't seem to be a shortage of weights here. Why there is in California, I don't know. But I will just private message me and I'll pick them up for you and take them back. So we're going to need a bench, a couch, something. We're going to remember the Bulgarians we did last week. Well, this week we're going to do the Bulgarian split squat, but we're going to hinge forward. So last week we dropped, we did a bicep curl with a shoulder press, and that's in the past. But so you got your bench, and will you also use it for a dumbbell pullover? So we're going to do a full body workout today. Hopefully we'll get through it twice. Good morning, Leanne. All right, let's get those feet nice and wide, guys. Let me start my time here. Make sure you work to how you feel. If you want to progress, I'll give you those. If you want to modify, I'll give you those as well. All right, let's take the feet nice and wide. Shift to the right side and then to the left. Place the hands on the quadricep, pushing back into the hips a little bit more. Oh, yes. Feeling the weight into the heel and the hip, the butt cheek. Side to side. Now let's take that right arm and reach it to the floor and pull. Palm is facing down, elbow reaches behind you. Good. Touch the floor, reach forward, whatever feels best for you. But if you can drop that chest at the same time while pushing the weight into the hips, I'll take it. Warming up inner thighs, body temperature. Good, one more, and then just back side to side. We're gonna take the opposite hand, reach it, and pull. Toe, knees, hips, facing straight forward. Pull. Gonna be a beautiful day. Every day is a great day that we're above ground. Reach, drive that elbow behind. Perfect. And last one, continue with the side to side. We're gonna lift that right leg and hold right here. Lift and hold, step it back out. Perfect. Little deceleration, a little more abdominal warm up. Body temperature, heating up. Good. Two more, and then we'll go back to the side to side, and we'll switch legs. Last one, side to side. Next one, lift that left side. Here we go, lift and hold. Press it out. Good. Morning, Michelle. Lift and hold. Finding that breath. Inhale, exhale. Push it out. I don't know about you guys, but last week, holy crap, I was a little sore through the tush and the obliques. Two more. Last one. Hold. Take that leg behind. Reverse lunge. Come up and switch. Good. Now, keep the feet apart. Try to bring that knee to the floor, drive your hips forward, reach the arms to the ceiling, hold down. Excellent. Oh, nice big stretch. Synovial fluid through your joints. Good, continue with the legs, take the arms wide, squeeze together. Shoulders drawn down, back tight. Telling yourself, I'm so glad I get to work out today. I feel so good. Don't stop, 10 seconds. Good. Body won't stop. Last one. Excellent. Okay. So two weights, one weight, no weight, whatever you want. I'm gonna grab two. 15. Now, if you have one weight, I want you to load the leg that's in front. Bulgarian split squat. So, foot's on the bench, nice and wide. So if you take the foot behind the standing leg, you're gonna be on a tightrope and it's gonna be a lot harder to balance. So give yourself some distance between your feet. This time, you're going to bend the back knee, hinge forward, and then straight back up. But keep this nice long spine. So this is the starting position, this is the ending position. Down and squeeze straight back up. The regression is drop your weight, or range of motion will be a little bit shorter. But guys, we're gonna do this for 1 minute, nice and slow. So look at your front heel. It stays anchored the whole time. Hinge your upper body forward, bend the back knee, straight back up. Abs are in tight. So is this more quad or is this more glute? This is more glute and hamstring. Straight up and down is more quad. You might feel it in your quad more. What does that mean? Might mean that you're not as strong as the hamstring and glute. It might mean that you worked your glute and hamstring yesterday, or your quad yesterday, right? That's been 15 seconds. See if you could tap those weights on the floor, going down lower, keeping the abs in tight. You notice I dropped one 15 pounder. Keep going, yes. Stephanie, keep that chest hinged over the quadricep. One more. Oh, holy glute. Oh, I love those. It's a love-hate relationship. All right, same thing, opposite side. Foot comes up, find your balance, gaze is forward, abs are in tight. Bend the back knee, hinge over, let's go. So now, notice when I come up, I stay hinged over. I avoid this. Okay, so try to keep that chest like a nice slope, pushing it to the floor. There we go. Come on, Shar. Guys, can we touch the floor? Come on, Lydia. Dancing, yeah. Is that Jody? Woo-hoo. You're past that halfway point. Front knee is behind the toes. Your heel is anchored. Good. Yes, you can. You got it. Come on, Leanne. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Excellent. All right. Set the weights off to the side. Dumbbell pullover. Slide my little handy dandy bench so I can demonstrate how to get on. So I'm gonna actually slide my butt right up against the bench. You're gonna hold the dumbbell like this, okay? So a triangle, elbow over here. Okay, sit just for a second. So, here is your dumbbell, holding like this, and you're gonna take it behind you with nice long arms. Your hips are bent, guys, so your hips need to be lower than your knees. Sit. Sit. You're on camera, listen. Sit. Sit. Oh. Sit. Sorry, guys. Sit down. Down. Thank you. Okay. So dumbbell pullover. You're gonna do this slow for 2 minutes. A lot of people like to elevate their hips. keep them low. Shoulders, head is on the bench. Hang on to the dumbbell nice and tight. Guys, drop your hips, inhale. Take it as far back into the floor as you can with nice long arms. Scoop it back to the ceiling. Yes or yes? Slow and controlled. Feel this down your armpit. Let's go. Now the reason I upped the time on this is because I want it slow. Once you get the weight right back over your chest, your arms are still long. Push to the point where you really feel the armpit engage. Everybody's range is a little different. Feel your arms lengthen away from your body and then let it go to the floor. If you feel more tricep, you're bending your elbows too much. Love what I'm seeing. Love, this is my favorite back exercise. Great lat work. Hips are still low. Yes or yes? Drop those hips. Guys, right there is 1 minute. Each one, you're going as low as you can. The wider your feet are on the floor, the better the center of gravity. The closer the feet together, less. So there's your progression. Coming in on the last 30 seconds. Inhale as you take it back. Exhale as you push it to the ceiling. Pull it to the ceiling. Yes. 15 seconds. Looking good, team. And last one. Great job. So good. All right. So depending on how high your bridge is, good boy. I'll push this away a little bit. We're gonna glute bridge with a chest press. Yes, yes? All right, so you're gonna put your feet up on the bench. Let's see, there's a 20. So your heels are up on the bench. If you don't have a bench, guys, you'll just do this on the floor and keep your hips lifted this time. So a little more glute. If you want more hamstring, keep your butt away from the bench. The farther your butt is away, the more hamstring. You want to work butt, bring it right up against it. So, chest press. Palms are facing your knees, dumbbells together. Shoulders are drawn down. Lift your hips, push the chest to the ceiling. Let your elbows come slightly to an angle towards your hips, tap the floor. Exhale, push up. 1 minute, are we ready? Here we go, 3, 2, keep the hips lifted. Press up. If the bridge is too much, put your feet flat on the floor. If you want to work core, put your legs in the tabletop. 3 options, progression. You could definitely lift one leg and then switch. You want to focus more on the chest, just drop the butt down on the floor. Good. 30 seconds right there. Make sure the shoulders are drawn down away from the ears. Squeeze at the top, slow on the down. Drive it up. Hold, down slow. Squeeze that grate right in the center of your chest at the top. 15 seconds, guys. Show me. Oh, yeah. So the palms are facing the knees, guys, not a chest fly. Chest press. The flies are where the palms face each other. You got it. 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, excellent. All right, come on up. Gonna elevate that heart rate. You're gonna do a front curtsy with a hammer curl. So we're staying to one side. The opposite side, we do a front curtsy with a bicep curl. Yes or yes? Are we good? Thumbs up? All right, so palms are facing up. All right, Lisa, you're here, okay? So I'm gonna step with my right leg first from cueing right, which will be my left. This leg stays forward. I'm gonna step about 2.5 feet in front, drop the back knee down to the floor. This is the modification. You curl right here, regular curl, push up, come straight back. Stay with that side. Now, the progression. You're here, hover the knee, curl, push back off, knee lift. Yes? So, you can always drop out the arms, you can always drop out and just do regular hammer bicep curls. 1 minute, only to the left side with the right knee, step in. 3, 2, front curtsy, down, curl, push off, knee lift. Perfect. So, you can also give me a front curtsy, push off, come back and curl. Yes. You can front curtsy, come off, knee lift, and curl. Many adjustments, many ways to find what feels good for you. I like it. There you go. Front curtsy. How are your legs feeling? So this curtsy's hitting the inner thigh. Outer thigh, yes, hamstring, but less than 10 seconds on this side. Got it. Excellent. One more. Let's crush it. Beautiful. All right. I'm going to switch my weights out for a curl. Thumbs up to the shoulders. So a hammer curl, opposite side. Are we ready? Ah, big breath. 3, you got it. 2, left leg, front curtsy. Curl. Come up, knee lift. There you go. I love it. Side view. So when I am lifting my hammer curls, notice my elbows do not move. They stay facing the floor. Yes or yes? Toe on that curtsy goes the same direction the knee is going. Try one of each. See where you feel the most challenged. You do you. God, love it. Less than 10 seconds. Woohoo! Last one. We got it. Great job. All right, guys, we're going into a W with a crunch. Here on the floor, heart rate's gonna come down. Palms are facing each other. As you crunch up, you come up, look at my elbows, they're going forward, but my back of my hand is going behind me like thumb is leading the way. If you have heavier weights, you're gonna be lower. Lighter weights, you're gonna make a bigger W, okay? So, here is the progression. Let me show you from direct. So, the weights are here, down slow. Inhale, exhale up, W. Pushing the chest forward, abs are in tight. The easiest, the weights are on the floor. You use your hands behind your neck, support your neck. Inhale, exhale, crunch up, grab the weights, a W. Anytime you can put the weights down during that crunch. Slow on the down, tucking the tailbone one vertebrae at a time. Quick on the up, give me that V-sit. There's another progression where you can lift your legs. Feel free, you won't see me doing that today. Now when you take those weights behind you, push the chest out and make sure you're not coming up too far to where you've lost the engagement in your core. Yes or yes? Guys, we're gonna do this one for 2 minutes. Let's go. Down slow. Inhale, exhale, W. Now this is working. The middle of your shoulder, medial deltoid, you're creating that external rotation for that medial deltoid. A deltoid goes towards the back, whereas most people think it goes to the front. It does not. So you're protecting it, and you're hitting a little bit of the posterior deltoid. Maybe a little bit of the anterior, yes. If you fatigue on the arm, keep going with just the crunch. Nice, Stephanie. Love it. Good, Michelle. Good, Char. Woo, baby. Notice your elbows go slightly forward as your hands go behind your head, behind your back. Oh, there it is. Love it. I love giving different cues versus counting so I can see where, who caught that cue. And all of a sudden they go, oh, now I know, right? If I tell you don't, you're gonna focus on that don't, and that's all you're gonna do. So I try to use the word avoid. Nice, Lydia. 30 seconds. I don't know about you guys, but I'm glad I got these orange bombs. A little weight. Oh yeah. And up. Last one. One more. One more. And gorgeous. All right, guys. Flip it over. We're going to do a kneeling tricep kickback. Now, the reason I like kneeling is your elbow, you can do it on the bench. You can really drop your chest and keep a nice, beautiful flat back. And the key is keeping the elbow to the ceiling, okay? From there, your arm hangs straight down from the elbow. Lock and release. As you fatigue, the elbow will come down. Yes or yes? So try not to start off here. Try to get it really high with the shoulder drawn down and the shoulder staying square to the floor. 1 minute, tricep kickback, let's go. Foot can be on the bench, foot can be on the floor. Good. Take your mind to your core right away, draw the belly button in, then go up to the shoulder. Pull the shoulder blade down. And once you get it in that locked position, Stephanie, I want you to hold it for a hot second. Hold, and then release. Yeah, I know. I want you to feel that burn. Good, Michelle. Good job. Get ready. Naj, where are you? Yes. 30 seconds. If you're getting a burn, that's exactly what you want. That's protein synthesis. That is the muscle. Woohoo! Grow it, baby. Coming in, last 15 seconds. Yes, you can. Oh, there you are, Naj. Come on, girl. I know. So had your elbow dropped a little bit. If it has, good. Then you know that you grabbed the exact weight that is challenging for you. Beautiful. Switch it, guys. Going right into the other side. Transition quickly. Going in 3, 2, let's go. So far, you've done chest, all lower body, core, shoulders, biceps, and triceps. We're going to repeat this in about 45 seconds. I'm on target today. Yay! I will tell you, the second round, the Bulgarian split squat, we're only going to do for 1 minute. Set up two. Yes. Good stuff. Keep pulling your abs in, guys. You got less than 15 seconds. Shoulders are still square to the floor. Yes, yes. Three, two, and lock it out. Nice work. All right. Bulgarian split squat. Grab that bench. One weight, loading on the leg that's in front. Two weights. Four. Whatever you want to give me, I'll take it. I'm going to start off with two. Doesn't matter what foot you start with. Just give yourself that distance. Here we go. Three. Bend the knee that's in front. Drive the chest forward. Drop your chin. Here we go. Down. Push up. Oh, yep, I am weightless right now. My legs are so fatigued from what I've been doing. 30 seconds. Just avoid stopping. Keep pushing through. Keep that chest driving forward towards the floor, out over that quadricep. Keep driving that leg that's in front, that hip behind you. Bend in the back knee. Less than 15 seconds. Stay over, Naj. I know. There you go. Yes, you got it. Three, two, one. Am I the only one that feels that right there? Oh. Ah! Love it tomorrow. All right, are we ready? Switching opposite side. Three, two, as in tight. Let's go. I don't know why I grabbed two on this side. Cool. If you want to increase your range of motion and you can't with the weight you have, drop them down. Still, you're going to get a burn. It's weight. Hey, Lydia. So some of you guys are lifting that chest. Look at me. I'm still hinging over, taking off down that ski slope. Old school style. Pass that halfway point. Good. Oh. Come on, less than 10 seconds. Yeah, you can. Good step. Come on. Three. Come on, Lisa. And last one. Excellent. Oh. All right, guys. Dumbbell pullover. 1 minute. If you only have two weights or you want it a little heavier, I'll take two weights, but keep them pushed together and make sure both sides are equal. Or you can do a kettlebell. Let's see. Grab my 25. You're doing this for 1 minute. So, grabbing the weight nice and secure. Shoulders head on the bench. Hips drop. Three, two, dumbbell pullover. A lot of core. Remember, yes, you can lift your hips, but what does that do? That takes away from you reaching the lat, clear down to that top of your iliac crest. with that back of your hip. Your lat goes clear down there. That's what we're trying to hit a little bit more of. Come on, you got it. Long arms. Avoid bending the elbows until you need to. Good. Oh yeah. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work, guys. All right, this time we're gonna do a chest fly instead of a chest press. Yes, you can bridge your feet, or you can just leave your feet flat on the floor, or you can tabletop the legs and extend the legs out or alternate as you go into the fly. So this time, palms are facing each other. Bend your elbows. Guys, you know the rule. Look at my elbows. They're here, not up here. So my elbows are slightly lower than my shoulder height. Now look where my wrist is. It's pretty much right around the elbow. It is not extended out. That's a tear, shoulder impingement waiting to happen. Protect yourself. 1 minute, I'm gonna go for the bridge. Keep my little tush in. Bridge up, here we go. Chest flies. Inhale down, exhale, squeeze to the top. When you're squeezing to the top, from the chest, not the arms. So the arms at the top of the squeeze, there's still a bend in both elbows. Check them out. See if you have that bend. Nice, Jar. Oh, you guys look so good. Yes. Woo! Less than 20 seconds. Show me, show me, show me. So good. Two more. Excellent. Last one. Boom. Excellent job, guys. All right, get some water if you need it. Come on up. We're going into front curtsy. Hammer curl, bicep curl, doesn't matter. We'll switch and then so you'll stay on one side. Doesn't matter which side you choose to do. I always like doing the regular curls first because they're a little bit harder. And then if my muscle fatigues, then I could go into the hammer curls and still get some good repetitions in. All right, so you choose the leg, just stay on that leg. Watch your front knee when you curtsy. 3, 2, here we go. Front curtsy, curl, push off, knee lift. Same side. And as you push off, you have the control so your abdominal to just lift the leg without taking that extra step. Extra focus, extra standing core. Woo! Thank you for joining me today. Guys are doing so good. Trust me, we all have those days. We're like, oh, I'm tired today. I didn't get enough sleep. Still join me, modify. I promise you'll feel better after. Woo-hoo. Yeah, baby. Almost there. Last one. Perfect. Hammer curl. Opposite side. Let's go. What if you have light weights? Curl at the bottom, curl at the top. What? Why not? Good job. Love what I'm seeing, guys. Pick your weights over cardio. What do I mean by that? Lift your weights, and then if you feel good, introduce your cardio. Why? You'll get way better results. Cardio is important, but if you notice, if you're incorporating legs with any of your workout, your heart rate, your breath is a little bit heavier here, yes? It's a form of cardio as well. Not the intensity, but that's okay. Last one. Excellent. The rule of thumb, if you find you like it this way, you'll find research that shows to your advantage. But remember, search for the truth. Have an open mind. What do you feel like is best for you? Do you like your cardio first? If you do, are you still lifting the heavy weights that you need to? Just a question to ask yourself. What's your goal, right? All right, guys, crunch with the W. 1 minute, 3, 2, talking down. Inhale, exhale, up. Beautiful W. Slow. I want you throwing the weight behind you. I want you controlling the weight behind you. Woo! Why? Did I grab these heavier weights? You guys are inspiring me. It's called visual correction, right? You know if somebody's watching you, do you end up pushing yourself a little bit more? I do. Nice, Stephanie. Gorgeous. You guys got it. You look so good. Excellent. 15 seconds. Resist going down fast. Tuck the tailbone one vertebrae at a time. That's your eccentric work on your core. Una más. Oh, wow. Ah, I love it. I love a good sweat. All right, kickbacks. Lean. Elbow nice and high. So some of you guys are doing this. Boom. And then just letting it drop. Squeeze, hold, lock. Slow, resist, resist, resist. Quick. Squeeze, hold, lock. Resist. 1 minute. Are you ready? Let's go.
Let's do it.
I tend to love triceps just because I can just see the difference right away. Like after a couple of times lifting triceps, literally in a week, you can see that definition. Now what makes a big difference? Starting to eat a little cleaner. Cut out your sugars. Don't cut them all out at once. Cut out one a day. Make yourself work for it. Reward yourself, or there's little games you play, right? I don't have any coffee until I've had a liter of water. Why do I like coffee? Kind of a social thing for me. Now it's a social thing with my husband. Yeah, good. Hold it there, Steph. Come on, Char. Woo-hoo. 10 seconds. One more. Excellent. Switching. Have plenty of time to cool you guys down and to stretch it out. All right, here we go. 3, 2, let's get it. Always is helpful if you have a partner. someone that likes to share working out with you, right? Versus someone that goes, I want to go to the gym today, and they go, oh, come on, let's just go have a cocktail. Let's go have dinner. I've had those friends. Oh, you can work out later. And it just gets me off track that fast, right? Rain check. Remember, you control you. Get it done and then say, hey, I'll meet you a little bit later. After I'm done with my workout for lunch. We can always make excuses, right? Last couple here, guys. 3, 2, give me one more. Excellent. Nice work. So good. All right. What I want you to do is go into a half pigeon. You're going to take the leg in front. Let me turn sideways and show you guys. So the leg is behind. Bent in front. Okay. So both hips are facing the same direction. So look down. If you need to, you can put a yoga block or a bender ball underneath that butt of the leg that's bent. But I want you to bring your elbows down to the floor and just reach forward. All of those curtsies, that's the area we're stretching. So give me a nice deep stretch. Shoulders down to the floor, whatever range feels best for you. Just breathe in. Excellent work today. So 2 times through. You know the routine if you want to do 3. Or you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Backyard Fitness by Cory, and watch it again. I will load it. Plenty of other workouts on there. Please smash the like button, comment. Helps my algorithm, and I really appreciate it. Come all the way up. Reach behind. Grab that foot with the right hand, with the left hand, either one. Just grab it and hold. Ooh, that is a side that is always tight. Gotta give it some extra love. So we're holding these positions for 45 seconds. That's what's important. Oh yeah, let's dance. That's what I miss. I miss going out dancing. Good, and release the leg. You're gonna spin that back leg around. The sole of the foot is in the inner thigh. You're gonna sit up tall. Take your hands and reach them shoulder height, and then cross over the knee and just hold. Now, this is hamstring. Try to avoid rounding. That's lower back, and we'll get to that in a second. If I'm facing you, I'm going across the knee, and I just hip hinge just a little, but I don't change the position of my pelvis. Good to see you, Renee. And now round. And just feel that go up to the upper back, which is part of that lat that you worked earlier. And forward fold over. Now the belly button in. Take a nice deep breath in through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Ah, that feels so good. Remember, make your cool down, your warm up, a ritual with every workout. It will help you from getting injured. Excellent. Come all the way up. We're going to pigeon the opposite side. And that leg behind and forward. Lift in the chest. Or coming down. To your elbows. So it depends where you're tight, right? Kind of mess around, play with it. If you lift your chest and you feel it more, then that's good. It's my life trick. Boom, 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 boom. It's my life trick. It's my life trick. Excellent. Come up and grab that foot behind. That's your quadriceps and hip flexor. I'm going to grab mine with my opposite hand. I'm going to lift my chest. If your heel cannot come up to your butt, it's okay. Try to square your shoulders to the floor. Good stuff. Or you can use a towel. You can use a yoga strap. Good. You act up, them boys in the back, and they won't think twice, just and react. Yeah. My life movie never hit, it's a wrap. Tell a hater, relax. Keep your shoulders drawn down. So team, remember, if you feel your lower back tomorrow, okay? Around this area, right here, that is where your lat was. So, not that you pulled something, take a little extra time, get on a tennis ball, roll your glutes, roll that area, spin that leg around, bring the hands forward, cross over the knee and just hip in just a little. Work hard, play hard, hot chicks on my radar, stay lit on that liquid till we black out like our Vader, squat it up with these hot bays and they stay south of the equator. Your belly button in, each time you feel the golden tendon organs release a little bit, and reach a little farther without bending your spine. So pushing the chest out. 10 seconds and then we'll round and we'll do that lower back. Good. Forward fold, round over. The same time you're pushing your sit bones away from your body. Bring the feet together, helping yourself up, coming all the way up. Give me a big inhale. Reach the right arm down the center of your back, opposite hand. Grab that elbow and pushes it down just a little bit farther. Feel that tricep. I got some good work today. Excellent. Release it and then opposite arm. Reaches down the center of the back. Good, and release, guys. Give me a big inhale, reaching it up, telling yourself you feel so good, glad you got to work out today. Bring the hands down to heart center. Excellent work.